गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर इंग्लिश लेक्चर। माय सेल्फ मिस अलीमा शेख। स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो वी हैड कंप्लीटेड यूनिट 1, राइट? सो नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल स्टार्ट विथ यूनिट 2। The very first poem, The Sugar Plum Tree. Students, the pic which is flashed on your mobile phone is the page number 25 of your English Balbhati textbook. So, the very first poem of Unit 2 is poem number 11, The Sugar Plum Tree. All of you observe this picture. What do you see here? Is it a tree? Yes? Can you tell me which tree is this? Can anyone? Students, this is a mango tree? No. Is it an apple tree? No. Then students, which tree is it? Can anyone say? Children, you can see this a little bit different kind of tree, as its fruits are also very different. So, can you guess the name of the tree? Okay, I will tell you. This is a sugar plum tree. And today we are going to learn about the sugar plum tree. The poem is written by Eugene Field. He is well known poet. This is a sweet poem. To send children after dreams to land of candies, lollipops and sugar. Let's begin with our poem. So children, first I am going to read whole poem for you and then I will explain you in stanza wise, means in paragraph wise. Okay? So come to the very first line. Have you ever heard of the sugar plum tree? It's a marvel of great renown. It blooms on the shore of the lollipop sea, in the garden of Shut-Eye Town. The fruit that eats bear is so wondrously sweet, as those who have tasted it say that the good little children have only to eat of that fruit to be happy next day. So students, a beautiful poem, a story which is generally narrated by Eugene Field. It is generally narrated to the children before they go to bed, so that they have sweet dream. ये जो sugar plum tree है, ये आमतौर पर बच्चों को कही जाती है। इसकी कहानी बच्चों को कही जाती है जब वो सोने जाते हैं, as a bed story, कि उन्हें अच्छे से नींद आए और दूसरे दिन वो happily उठे। So students, now come to the very first line. Have you ever heard of the sugar plum tree? Means, students, it's a very beautiful poem. And the whole poem is about imagination. ये बहुत अच्छी poem है और ये poem fully imagination है. Means, कल्पना है. Now, First line, have you ever heard of the sugar plum tree? Means, here the poet asking us that, do you ever hear of sugar plum tree? Ever means kabhi. Heard means suna hai. क्या आपने कभी सुना है शुगर प्लम ट्री के बारे में? नाउ स्टूडेंट सेकेंड लाइन, इट्स अ मार्वल ऑफ ग्रेट रिनोम. चिल्ड्रन हियर द वर्ड टी आई एस इज मीन्स इट इज अ मार्वल. स्टूडेंट्स मार्वल का मतलब होता है एक बहुत ही खूबसूरत चीज. A wonderful thing. Great renown means बहुत ज्यादा famous होता है. उसे बहुत हम great renown कहते हैं. Right? As you know, it's famous. If something is of great renown, it is famous. It is known as to many people as a good thing. It's called a renown, means famous. Now students, the third line, it blooms on the shore of the lollipop sea. Students, blooms means phoolo ka khilna on the shore. Students, shore means near to the सी साइड. शोर का मतलब है समुंदर का किनारा. जब शुगर प्लम ट्री है वो ब्लूम्स होता है, उसमें फ्लावर्स आते हैं. कहां पर आते हैं? ऑन द शोर ऑफ द लॉलीपॉप सी. स्टूडेंट्स लॉलीपॉप समुंदर के किनारे पर फ्लावर्स आते हैं, ब्लूम्स होता है. अंडरस्टूड? नाउ द फोर्थ लाइन, इन द गार्डन ऑफ शटाई टाउन मींस जो शटाई टाउन का गार्डन है उसमें शटाई टाउन का मतलब है आंखें बंद. तो जब आप सो जाते हो या सोने जाते हो, when you go to sleep and then when you see your dreams, the sugar plum tree will start blooming. Means वो sugar plum tree में flowers खिल जाते हैं. Right students? So everyone understood the four line? Students, again I'm going to read the four line. So everyone just see. Have you ever heard of the sugar plum tree? It's a marvel of great renown. It blooms on the shore of the lollipop sea in the garden of Shattai town. So students, everyone understood the first stanza. Now move to the second stanza, means the second paragraph. The fruit that is bears is so wondrously sweet. Means students, the fruit that it bears, the fruit is very sweet, is so wondrously sweet. Students, wondrously means wonderfully, amazingly. Jo fruit aate hain wo bahut hi स्वीट होते हैं. राइट? एज दोज हु हैव टेस्टेड इट से मींस जिसने भी खाया है वो कहता है. स्टूडेंट्स आई हैड एक्सप्लेन यू द टू लाइन्स ऑफ द सेकेंड स्टेंजा. अगेन आई एम सेइंग द फ्रूट दैट इज बियर्स इज सो वंडरसली स्वीट means the fruit is very sweet, and wondrously means wonderfully, amazingly. Jo fruit आते हैं शुगर प्लम ट्री में, वो बहुत ही स्वीट होते हैं। एज दोज हू हैव टेस्टेड इट से, मीन्स जिसने भी खाया है वो कहता है। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट लाइन, दैट द गुड लिटिल चिल्ड्रन हैव ओनली टू ईट, मीन्स द चिल्ड्रन दोज आर गुड, दे मस्ट हैव टू ईट दिस फ्रूट, मीन्स जो अच्छे बच्चे होते हैं, जो छोटे बच्चे होते हैं उन्हें ही खाना चाहिए, ऐसे पोएट हमसे कह रहे हैं। नाउ स्टूडेंट द लास्ट लाइन, ऑफ दैट फ्रूट टू बी हैप्पी नेक्स्ट डे, मीन्स द स्मॉल किड्स, द गुड लिटिल चिल्ड्रंस, दे मस्ट हैव टू ईट एंड व्हेन दे ईट दिस फ्रूट दे विल बी हैप्पी टिल द नेक्स्ट डे। जैसे कि छोटे बच्चे, अच्छे बच्चे खाना चाहिए क्योंकि वो दूसरे दिन तक वो खुश रह सके। सो स्टूडेंट्स एवरीवन अंडरस्टूड द पोयम? ओके, नाउ स्टूडेंट्स आई एम गोइंग टू रीड द पोयम अगेन फॉर यू, ऑल ऑफ यू जस्ट रिपीट आफ्टर मी। यूनिट टू, पोयम नंबर 11, द शुगर प्लम ट्री। Have you ever heard of the sugar plum tree? It's a marvel of great renown. It blooms on the shore of the lollipop sea in the garden of Shut Eye Town. The fruits that it bears is so wondrously sweet, as those who have tasted it say that the good little children have only to eat of that fruit to be happy next day from the sugar plum tree. Written by Eugene Field. So students, everyone understood the poem? Now students, you have to write this whole poem one time in your English notebook. Students, plus I am going to give you the new words, that also you have to write two times in your English notebook, means dictation words, that also you have to write two times in your English notebook. Students, the pig witch's flash on your mobile phone is the homework part. That homework you have to write down in the English notebook. So come to the very first one, poem number 11, the sugar plum tree. In that, new words means dictation words. The very first word, it's marvel. Second one, renown. Third word, sugar plum. Fourth word, blooms. Fifth word, lollipop. Sixth word, shut eye town. Seventh word, tasted. Eighth word, wondrously. Ninth word, bears. Tenth one, shore. So students, this 10 new words you have to write down in your English book. This part you have to write two times. So students, today I had given you two homeworks. First, you have to write down the poem. The whole poem you have to write down one time. And the second homework is you have to write the new words. Total 10 new words are there that you have to write two times. So students, everyone understood the poem? And notes I will give you in the next lecture. Okay students? So now, student, I'm going to explain you grammar. And the topic is comprehension.
right? So students, combined book number 2, as you know, combined book number 1 we had completed, right? So now the next unit means unit 2, we have to take combined book number 2. So everyone, just remove your combined book number 2 and take out your pencil also. Students, page number 31, as the pic which is flash on your mobile phone is the page number 31 of your combined book number 2. English grammar and composition. From page number 31 to 57, there is a grammar part. Right, student? So here, page number 32. Chapter number 7, comprehension. It is the grammar part. Okay, students, again I am saying it's a grammar part. And in that, lesson number 7, comprehension. Understood, students? Here we have a short story in front of us. First, we will read the story and then we have to answer some questions. Students, again I am saying, first we will read the story and then we have to answer some question. So, reading the story and answering the question related to the story is known as comprehension. So, what is comprehension, student? Reading the paragraph and answering the question related to the paragraph is known as comprehension. So, here the story in front of you. The title is Time with Grandfather. So, here the title is Time with Grandfather. Let's see. Now, the very first line. Rahul jumped from bed. The sun was peeping through his window. So, Rahul is a boy, right? What is the name of the boy? Students, what is the name of the boy? Yes, it's Rahul. He jumped from his bed. So, Rahul is sleeping on a bed. Right, student? When he waked up, he jumped from his bed. The sun was peeping. So, at what time sun rises, students? Can anyone say the answer? Yes, it's the morning time. The sun rises. The sun peeping. Students, peeping means looking through his window. So, might be the window is open and the sun has risen and it's looking from window inside the house. And what Rahul did? Yes, can anyone say what Rahul has did? He jumped from his bed, right? He quickly takes down his bag and puts some of his favorite things. It's time to visit grandfather's or Ajah's, as he calls him. So here, Rahul was very excited because he wants to visit grandfather's house. Means, he wants to meet his grandfather. Or you can say, Ajah. So, what he did? He quickly taken his bag and whatever his favorite things, he put inside the bag. For example, student, if you are going someone else's house for many days to stay, what you do? Yes, you pack your favorite things in your bag, right? So, same way, Rahul put his favorite things in his bag because he is going to meet his grandfather, to whom he called Ajah. What he called to his grandfather? Yes, it's Ajah. He puts in his garden toolkit his favorite storybook,
his toy car and his stuffed bear Snoopy. If I ask you, students, what are things did Rahul put inside his bag? Yes, garden tool. Students, garden tool means might be he is doing gardening. If he is going to his grandfather's house, he might be doing gardening. For that reason, he is taking garden tools with him. Second thing, then he put his favorite storybook. He put his toy car and then his stuffy bear Snoopy. And he gave name to his teddy bear, it's Snoopy. Now students, as I had completed the first paragraph, now move to the second paragraph. Going to Aja's village for one whole month. So now, for the whole month, he wants to spend with his grandfather, means Aja. It was his favorite part of the summer vacation. So, when he goes to Aja's place, students, where he goes to Aja's place, can anyone say? Yes, it's summer vacation time. As you know, in summer vacation, you get 2 months holidays, right? Yes, students, in summer vacation, you get 2 months holiday. At that time, Rahul wants to go to grandfather's house. So here, Rahul is planning to spend his summer vacation with his grandfather, to whom he called Aja. Aja will take him to the weekly market and also teach him to lay flower beds. So, what Aja does with Rahul? Can anyone say the answer? Yes, Aja take Rahul to weekly market. Students, weekly market means Sunday to Sunday we say Sunday market, right? Or maybe Saturday to Saturday market. Means weekly Saturday there will be market, like that. Aja takes Rahul to weekly market. Aja takes him weekly market and Aja explained Rahul how to plant a flower. Lay flower beds means planting flower. Aja teach Rahul how to plant a flower. So, student, everyone understood the second paragraph. Now move to the third paragraph. Last year, when he was 7 years old. So, now Rahul is 8 years, right, students? Because last year he was 7. So, might be he is 8 years now. Aja had planted and grown some vegetables. So, what Aja taught him? How to grow and plant some vegetables. Right, students? Of course, with Rahul's help. Aja was patient and did not mind taking many hours to teach Rahul how to dig the soil. Now here, to teach someone, to explain someone, we required patience. Students, what is the meaning of patience? Patience here means time. Not to get irritated. If the person is not understanding what you are explaining, so you have to explain again and again. You should not get angry on that person. It's called patient. Patient here means explaining someone without getting angry or irritated. So here, Aja is having lots of patience. Why? Because it is not easy to explain
Rahul about planting, means how to plant vegetables and flowers. So it's take time, and Ajja is having patient, so he slowly explain Rahul, means slow wise he explain Rahul again and again how to dig the soil, show the seeds and water the saplings. So all these things take time for Rahul to learn. But Ajja did not lose temper, did not got impatient, did not got angry on Rahul. Ajja nicely explained everything about planting to Rahul. Because of this, only Rahul loved to spend time with his grandfather, because his grandfather is very polite. He explained him new things. He take him to the weekly market. He spent quietly time with Rahul. And this is all things that Rahul love. Ajja is here. Rahul, mother knocks on his door. Are you ready? Now, here, mother came in the morning. Might be Rahul is inside the room. And mother is knocking at the door. Mother is saying, Ajja is here, means Ajja has came. Rahul, are you ready to go to Ajja's place? Yes, mom, I will be there at once, Rahul says with a broad smile. Means with a big smile, Rahul says, yes, mom, I am coming in a minute, with a great smile. So this was the story of Rahul and his grandfather. Now, related to this story, I will ask you some questions, students. Looking to this story and by understanding this story, you have to give me the answer. That is known as comprehension. So now, students, I'm going to ask you some question and you have to give the answers to me. So students, the pic which is flash on your mobile phone is the page number 33. There are 8 questions are there, right? Related to this comprehension. You have to give the answer by understanding and reading the paragraph which I had explained you. Related to that paragraph, I am going to ask you some questions. Okay, students? Tick the correct answer for the questions given below. In that, the very first one, Rahul jumps out of bed because. Options: A1, he is late. B1, he is scared. C1, he is excited. The answer is C1, he is excited. So students, put a tick, right mark in that circle. Now the second one, how old is Rahul? Options: A1, 7 years old. B1, 8 years old. C1, 9 years old. So students, how old is Rahul? Yes, you are right. It's B1, 8 year old. So students, in the circle, put a right mark. Now the third one, what time of the year is it? Options: A1 summer, B1 winter, C1 spring. So the answer is summer, means the A1. So students, put a right mark. Now the fourth question, what is Rahul's favorite part of the summer vacation? Options are A1 gardening, B1 going to the weekly market, C1 visiting grandfather's village. So students, which is the answer? Yes, C1, visiting grandfather's village. So put a right mark. Fifth one, what had
are just planted last year.
So students, in a story I had explained you.
What had Aja planted last year? Can anyone say the answer?
Yes.
The options are flowering plants, B1 vegetables, C1 fruits.
Yes, the answer is vegetables.
Students, all the answer you can get in the paragraph which I had explained you. In that only all the answers are there. Now the sixth one. Who is Snoopy? Options: Rahul's car, B1, Rahul's stuffed bear, C1, grandfather.
Yes, the answer is B1, Rahul's stuffed bear.
Now the seventh one. What does the word patient mean here? Option A1, very slow, B1, sick in the hospital, C1, lacking to share things, D1, taking time without complaints.
Yes, patient means taking time without complaint. So the answer is D1. Put a right mark in the circle.
The last one. Where and when does this story take place? Options A1, at Rahul's home in the morning, B1, at Grandpa home in the afternoon, C1, at Rahul's home in the afternoon, the D1, at Grandpa's home in the morning. Where and when does this story take place? The answer is A1, at Rahul's home in the morning.
So students, all the answers you can get in the paragraph, or you can say in the story. All the answers are there. So I hope you all have understood, right students, what is the meaning of comprehension. Students, again I am saying, comprehension means the passage, or you can say the paragraph or story. It is given, right, which you have to read and related to the paragraph or story, you have to find the answers from the paragraph. Whichever the questions is given, you have to find out the answer from the paragraph, or maybe it is a story, you have to find out, right? This process is called as comprehension. So students, everyone understood properly now? Okay. Students, today I had explained you the poem, the sugar plum tree, as well as the grammar part. In that, I had explained you the topic is comprehension, right? So students, if you have any doubt regarding the explanation or about the homework, you can call me or WhatsApp me on my personal number. So thank you for watching the video.